Hi, I'm Jared Nelson from the Investing Channel, and welcome to The Spill. So, Leggett and Platt increased its dividend for the last 50 years consecutively. The manufacturer of C components and products for homes, offices, and autos embarked on a strategic transformation back in 2007. Its goal? Divest from low-performing businesses and improve margins and returns. And step one is now complete. As the company moves into phase two, it faces supply chain challenges that plague many manufacturers today. However, we feel the current share price creates an opportunity for investors with a multi-year outlook to dip their toes in the water. And with a mammoth 4% dividend and investment-grade balance sheet, we expect a broader rotation into financially sound companies to benefit LEG. Plus, it's the top home product stock search amongst financial pros in December. So we know there's interest amongst the big players. And management plans to grow revenues at 6-9% annually through a combination of organic growth and acquisitions. And looking at the financials, like most manufacturers, LEG took a hit in 2020 as COVID shuttered operations and dampened demand. Otherwise, the company shows fairly consistent revenue growth when you take into account the various divestments and acquisitions over the last decade. More importantly, its margins improved as the company shed poor-performing assets. Plus, management delivered shareholder-friendly returns with a growing dividend and sizable share buyback. Additionally, increased raw material costs pushed margins lower by a significant amount. However, we expect supply chain issues to abate next year, while the company increases prices to recover lost margins. Lastly, we want to highlight LEG's fortress balance sheet. Currently, there is less than $1.8 billion in long-term debt on the company's balance sheet. In fact, the company has a current asset-to-liability ratio of 1.64 and a total asset-to-total debt ratio of 1.43. Moving to valuations, our analysis delivered some interesting results. While current price puts LEG at a discount to its own 5-year average in several cases, the company trades at a premium to the consumer discretionary sector. Its price-to-earnings gap ratios are slightly better than the sector average, but non-gap ratios are not. We believe a lot of this boils down to the speed at which labor, raw materials, and transportation costs have hit LEG compared to the company's price increases. As noted earlier, once the increases catch up to inflation, we expect margins and cash flows to improve. In our opinion, this is a 9 out of 10 opportunity, and while we would prefer a bigger discount, the current share prices provide a nice value. And the massive dividend can be reinvested to juice up returns. At $40 per share, we see upside to $50 to $55 over the next several years. Coupled with a reinvested dividend, investors could look for an annual return of around 15%. Click and subscribe to the Spill newsletter to get the full breakdown.